I've been listening to Travis Scott lately. But also today people are coming to our house to put this in and they're gonna be here for like 6 hours. Which I am not excited about because I'm scared of people.
They're here.
Oh my god, they're coming inside.
What?
How am I supposed to leave my bathroom?
So then I called my mom.
How am I supposed to go anywhere?
You
say it like it's easy.
So I left my bathroom and they were here. And so I slowly walked through the hallway and then I heard them coming. So then I ran into my room. I barely made it.
Imagine going into strangers' houses for over like 6 hours.
Ew! Ew!
So I'm leaving the house.
I really don't want to go back home.
My social anxiety is like up in arms right now.
Oh my god, it's a worm.
I love me a good worm. Oh.
Oh. It's wet outside. Also, I had a chicken sandwich from McDonald's for the first time last week, and oh my god! Puffed my cherry, girl. I want more! I wish my first sexual experience made me feel that way.
20 minutes later.
Can I get 2 spicy McChickens? And can they be, like, really spicy? I want it to, like, burn my butthole.
You want it to what?
Can I have no mayonnaise, please? Ironically, I don't like white sauces. Okay, I should have been filming because the girl recognized me. Did you know I'm so tight that this would be a struggle to get inside of me? Who wants to find out? Just kidding. I ain't no whore. Better than sex, y'all. Why is there a penis on it? Today I'm getting my first pedicure.
Okay, feet reveal.
And I'm like really nervous. If you don't know, I hate feet. I hate looking at your feet. I hate anybody touching or looking at my feet. I'm that psychopath that sleeps with socks on.
Ow.
Bitch! Toes do not bug me at all.
Why don't you like them?
Do you have a foot fetish?
I don't have a foot fetish, but I don't think toes are ugly. Unless I see some nasty shit growing between them.
Is it weird to still have socks on when you're doing it?
Today I'm taking the dogs for a walk all by myself.
Doggies, time for a walk.
Ginger, I know you're old, but like you can still get up once in a while.
You can move faster than that. Come on, waddle to the door.
You are literally so slow.
Y'all, I cannot do this with one hand. Come on, Ginger. You don't get to be lazy right now. Ginger.
What the fuck did I do?
And of course, Miss Slow Ass had to stop to take a dump.
Of course.
Ew.
Literally so over it.
You do not have to piss 10 times a walk.
I almost just got hit by a car because somebody thought it was appropriate to drive 80 miles an hour around a corner.
Miska, calm down. Ginger, you're so pitiful.
Are you ready?
What?
Go, 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 go.
Ooh.
You think you deserve a cookie just because you walked?
My man.
This is for doing the bare minimum.
And I get nothing.
So I just finished working out and of course I have to shower, but our hot water isn't working.
Not to sound like a little bitch or anything, but I'm not about to take a cold shower.
I can't shave my legs with goosebumps.
I have decided that I am going to boil water. Where's the pot?
How do we lose a pot?
Apparently my dad left it in their bathroom.
Ugh. Annoying.
So I filled up the pot, but then in the bathtub-
Ew, there's hairs in the bathtub. Ugh. Okay, the water's boiling.
So I brought the water to the tub and then poured it in.
Time to get naked. Ew, do I have a booger?
But then when I stepped into the tub.
Ow, 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 ow.
It's like burning my feet off.
12 seconds later.
Okay, now I'm cold.
I forgot my underwear.
But I still put my pants on.
Oh, and also I took this booty pic.
So I saw this video about these mints, which apparently make your mouth water a ton. But they said it's like used for, you know. You know, so of course I had to try them. So I got 3 kinds, and apparently this is the strongest one. It makes your mouth water the most. So, okay, here we go. Should I get something to suck on?
Do you have anything long or something that I can suck on?
What? She said no. Okay, we're just gonna go.
Ew. I'm really getting the juices going.
A few moments later.
Ew. My tongue is tingling. Ew. Oh my God. Ooh.
Oh, hey. Can I have a minute?
So the other day, I was going to the living room to try these special mints. And when I was sitting down, my dad came in the room and was like,
ooh, are those mints? Can I try a mint?
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. But these mints actually make your mouth water a ton. And apparently, actors and actresses in, like, naughty films use them. So then, like, you know, they can, like, and it's, like, really wet.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. That's why I got them.
And then my mom came in the room.
You should let your mom try one. Oh yeah, I was gonna try one. I mean, I was gonna let her try. Oh. Wait a second. Oh.
Things I do because I've been a single little whore for my entire life.
Your dad.
So the other night I went on a date. Please don't ask me how it went.
I swear I'm never going to meet anybody. Also, I don't know why I have to say this, but I don't, like, need to have sex. I didn't know going on a date with somebody meant that, like...
But anyways, I came home and I went inside.
I'm home.
And I walked over to my parents, and of course my mom had to ask.
How did it go?
It was fine.
And then my dad was like...
Did you hook up?
Oh.
No.
Because that's not what I want. That's all anybody ever wants. Unfortunately for me, I couldn't find the person that I wanted to be with for the rest of my life when I was 19 years old.
For what? What the fuck did I do?
Sorry, I asked.
Things I do because I'm single that may or may not be weird. Let me know. Every night when I go to bed, I think about somebody that I think is hot. For example, Tom Hardy. But not just like any Tom Hardy. Tom Hardy from Venom.
Aw.
He gets my juices flowing, girl. And I'll pretend I'm in a relationship with him. And I'll be like,
babe, are you ready to come to bed?
Oh yeah, I'm coming. Mm.
Mm-hmm. Are you ready to give me that Venom?
I'm just kidding. I'm actually way more PG than that. So instead, I'll just pretend that him and I are getting in bed together, and then he spoons me while we sleep. When in reality, it's just pillows wrapped up in blankets that I sleep with every night. So I just went to 7-Eleven to get a Slurpee, like always. And when I was getting in line to check out, the guy in line in front of me was really hot. I was like... But while waiting in line, I was just kind of looking around, and I looked behind me, and the guy behind me was super hot as well. And I was like,
oh my God.
What a dream, being in between two really hot guys. And then suddenly the guy behind me said,
hey man, I like your shoes.
And I was like,
I wanna have your babies.
Just kidding, I obviously didn't say that. I actually was like,
oh. Thank you.
Yeah.
I can't believe a really hot guy just gave me a compliment. Even though it was just about my shoes and it wasn't about me and he probably has a girlfriend, but like, I still loved it. It made my day. So I posted a video of me holding up a turkey baster and my douche in front of my parents because I thought it was funny. But apparently a lot of people were annoyed and upset at me because I was able to do this in front of my parents. For example, I'm sure the parents didn't need to know any of this. How embarrassing for them.
Shut your butt.
Oh gosh, that's so disrespectful for your parents. I mean, it's good to see a bottom is keeping it clean, but why his parents need to see this, I don't know. There's certain things I don't share with my folks for mine and their benefit. I sure shit wouldn't be manufacturing and capturing these moments on film. I'm not sure why the fact that I'm open and able to share things with my parents upsets everybody so much, but I'm sorry. I'm sorry that you can't be open with your parents about things that normal people do all the time, and that my parents don't shame me for that. Thank you for listening. So the other day I was getting in my car, and I always put my money in this little pocket on my backpack. And then a little bit later, I found some dirty change in my car, and I was going to put it in the little pouch. But then the zipper stopped moving.
Oh, fuck.
So I ran into the house and into my bathroom to try and fix it. And I was trying to move the zipper, but it was still stuck. When finally I was able to pull the bill out that it was stuck on, and that much of it tore into the zipper.
I literally never buy expensive things like this because I think it's kind of ridiculous. My $1,400 backpack gets ruined by a $1 bill. The irony. This would only happen to me.
So I got tweezers and started plucking out as much of the paper that I could. I was going to cry. It literally took me about an hour until finally
I was literally going to be so upset.
But I did it! I did something with no help. Thank you.